One of the things that I really love about Asana are templates. The templates actually make it really, really easy so that you have maybe a checklist of things that you need to get done. All you need to do is anytime you have a new project coming up or a new task coming up, you could just use that template. So that's what I'm going to be covering in this video, is how to actually create templates inside of Asana so that it makes it easy for you to not only get more work done, but also so you don't have to keep remembering what you need to put into your checklist. Hey, my name is Burhan, and if you're new to the channel, I talk about online business and I talk about automations. I talk about how to actually use computers, use automated tools such as templates in Asana to actually make your life a little bit easier and actually build your business. So let's get into the content right now. Let's get into the templates. And so you can see inside of my Asana, I've got this particular task called IG Carousel, 10 ways to use the Asana effectively. And I want to use this as a template because I've got a couple of subtasks over here that I think is going to be interesting. So what I'm going to do now is, obviously this has got a specific title on it and it can actually be created as a template. So what we're going to do is we are going to convert this task as a template by just clicking on those three little dots on the corner. And Asana is going to go do its thing. It's got this little squiggly line thingy you can see under my face happening. And now it's created this template. And so now what it's done is it's taken this task and it's grayed it out because it's closed and converted it to a template, which is perfectly fine. Now, if I wanted to actually use that template, I go over here and I say add new. And instead of choosing task, section, or milestone, I'm going to create a template. And so what you can see right here immediately is it's using the template that I just created. It's put the exact same name in here and it has put in this description that I had initially, and it has added in the tasks, and it's even put in the dates and the people that I needed to allocate these tasks to. And so this is very interesting because obviously I had a name that was a task before. So if I wanted to edit that template, because I don't want to get confused and saying, oh, every single one is an Instagram carousel that is with this title that has these dates that is inside of this section as such as such. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make changes here so that I can have multiple templates maybe for, let's say, Instagram carousels. And so maybe what I would do is change this to title, and maybe it's going to go into the ideas section. I'm going to remove the date for now because we don't need to have the dates. We have the allocations, but you know, once when things are in the idea phase, we're not really sure if we're going to take the ideas forward. And so keeping a date on this task, on the subtask, might not be a good idea. The post stage, I'm going to put as idea. And this is definitely for an IG post. And that's particularly fine. So, and this is going to be a carousel, right? So we've got the stage as idea. We've got the carousel. We've got it for the social channel of Instagram. We don't need any participants. There are no dependencies. We know that the caption is going to go underneath here, and we know that the hashtags are going to go over here. So now this is looking more like a template. So let's do exactly the same thing. We hit the three dots, convert the task to a template. Asana is going to be doing its thing. It'll take this task and basically convert it. And I can now go ahead and actually delete that task. And I'm going to delete the other one that I had just now. The way I'm deleting it is just right clicking on the task and deleting the task that way. And so you can see that there's notifications on the left side here. All right, so now we have two templates where we've got the one that we had before, which was not very well done, but we've got the one that was actually the one that we wanted to do. So if I create that, it's now gonna default me to change the title. And so I can very easily go here, 9 ways to get more followers using IG Reels. Now this is going to be an interesting post because if I make a carousel about how to make IG Reels to get more followers, that's kind of like interesting. So you can see right now that all the things have been set up. It's all looking great. And the dates as I've set it up initially were done. Asana did its job. All right, now what I want to show you very quickly is how to actually edit a template or have a template changed. And so if I go here to to customize, you can see the two templates that are here, and that's the two ways that I can actually use this template, is to either use the customize or add new. But basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to edit that. And so if I wanted to change the template over here like this, I could change it here, or I could just delete this template because we no longer need it. We have this particular one. So I've shown you two ways to basically edit the template. One is by actually recreating a task and then editing it, making it a template and then using it as a template. Or if you have an existing template that you wanted to change, you can go here into the customize menu and then change that template here. So I think that gives you everything that you need to use a template tasks inside of Asana. So if you like the video, hit the like. And here's a playlist that I've actually got talking a little bit more about productivity and Asana and how to actually build your business using Asana. So with that being said, thank you so much, and I'll catch you on the next one. Bye.